हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई प्रोफेसर संतोष बंसोड़े वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर ए लेक्चर ऑन असाइनमेंट मॉडल। इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज टुडे आई विल डिस्कस मल्टीपल सॉल्यूशन केस इन असाइनमेंट मॉडल। बट बिफोर दैट आई होप यू हैव सीन माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ असाइनमेंट मॉडल। आई एक्सप्लेन देयर द कंप्लीट प्रोसीजर ऑफ हंगेरियन असाइनमेंट मेथड एंड वेरियस स्टेप्स। होप यू हैव नोटेड इट or either you have memorized it. Now let us go to the problem. The problem statement is, the five jobs are to be done on five different machines. The cost of producing ith job on the jth machine is given below. Assign the jobs to different machines so as to minimize the total cost. So in this table, the various costs of processing the jobs on various machines are given. Now if you look at the number of rows and columns, this is a square matrix, and this is the requirement of Hungarian assignment method to obtain the solution. So this is a balanced assignment problem. Now if I revise here the various steps involved in the Hungarian assignment method, those are row operation, column operation, making assignments, check for optimality, if the solution is optimum, give the answer. If solution is non-optimal, then improve that solution by drawing minimum number of lines, then modify the table and again check for optimality. These are the steps involved in Hungarian assignment method. Now let us perform first row operation. So what is row operation? For every row, check or locate the smallest value in that row and subtract that value from all the row elements. Similarly for second row, third row, and fourth and fifth rows. Now we get the table as this one after row operation. At the place of minimum values in the corresponding rows, we obtain here the zero element. Once the row operation is completed, we have to go for column operation. The column operation is performed on the table of row operation. Along the columns, we have to locate the smallest value, then subtract that value from each of the column elements. Now for first column, minimum value is 0. So if we subtract 0 from all the elements, these column values remains same. That is, they are unchanged. But in the second column, smallest value is 2. So subtract 2 from all the elements, we get this new column. Similarly, perform the column operations and get the new table. So this is the table after column operation. Now once we complete the column operation process, we get at least one zero element in each of the rows or columns. And then once we get at least one zero in each row or column, we can make here assignments. So if you observe this table, first assignment will be made on this 0. Why? That is, we can draw a square. Why? If you observe first row, it has multiple zeros. That's why it is to be skipped. In the next row, we have to observe. It has only one 0. That's why it should be assigned. It should be crossed. Why? This row has only one 0. So in the corresponding column, if there are multiple zeros, they need to be crossed. So this concept is applied here for making assignments. So this zero is first assigned, this is crossed. Then check which of the rows have a single zero, at exact zero. It has multiple zeros, it has multiple zeros, it has multiple zeros. Therefore skip the assignments along the rows. Now check along the columns, which column has exact 1 0, go sequentially. As first column is assigned, observe second column. Here only 1 0 is present, so assign this one first and cross the remaining zeros in the respective rows. Now if you observe here, fourth and fifth rows have multiple zeros. Also, fourth and fifth columns have multiple zeros. So in such a case, you can assign randomly. It doesn't have any effect on your final answer. Now all the zeros are either assigned or crossed. Now if you check the condition for optimality, here number of assignments, that is number of zeros assigned, are 4, number of rows or columns are 5 here. So therefore 4 is not equal to 5, therefore the solution is non-optimal. Now as a solution is non-optimal, we have to proceed to improve the existing solution. Now what you will do here, as per our procedure, we have to mark the rows and columns to draw the minimum number of lines. Now to draw the minimum number of lines, first step is to mark a row which has unassigned zeros. So row number 3 has unassigned zeros, so mark this row first, then consider corresponding column and mark it. Now consider again marked column and assigned zero. So corresponding row is to be marked. For marking process, I have given here the sequence 1, 2, 3. You follow it so that you can mark the rows and columns. Up to here, this marking process is to be done. Up to where a row contains unassigned zeros. So there are no further possibilities there for marking a row which has unassigned zeros. There is only one. Now we have to draw the lines for unmarked rows. For unmarked rows, let us draw the lines and mark the columns. So it covers all the zero elements, either crossed or assigned. Now locate smallest uncovered element. Uncovered elements means those elements in which lines don't pass here. And the covered elements are those where the line passes. Now from our point of view, here important element is smallest uncovered element. For the new table, smallest uncovered element is important. Subtract the smallest value from all the uncovered elements and add this value at the intersections of lines. The covered elements will remain same, they will not change. So new table we get is this one. Among the uncovered elements, 4 is the minimum element. Subtract from all the uncovered elements and add same to the elements corresponding to the intersection of lines. So the step is mentioned here, and we get this new matrix. Now once we get the new matrix, again we have to check for optimality. Now when we are checking for optimality, we have to start the assignment. But if you observe here, this table, before making assignments, it has multiple zeros in all the rows. So we cannot initiate first assignment along the rows. Now check for the columns, which of the columns sequentially which has exactly one zero. Now if you observe here, in the first column there are multiple zeros, two zeros, but in the second column there is only one zero. Therefore we will make first assignment here, and corresponding zeros in that row will be crossed. So your first assignment will be here. Now check again which of the rows or columns have exact one zero, but there is no further possibility. These rows and columns have multiple zeros. So in that case, what we have to do, that is explained in the next slide. Now here are multiple alternative solutions. As we said, we have made assignment here, right? Now these zeros are crossed. Now if you observe remaining rows and columns, all of them have multiple zeros. So randomly let us make first assignment here and cross corresponding zeros in the rows and columns. So I will cross this zero and this zero. Now if I again observe along the rows, I observe here this row has exact one zero, so I will make assignment here. And further, if there are any zeros, I will cross them. Now again, there are multiple zeros here across these rows and columns. So for, as there is a case of multiple solutions, I assign here randomly this first zero, I will cross them, and at last I will assign this one. So this is the first possibility of solution. Now I go for next case. Now instead of, I assign this one because this has only one zero first. Similar assignment is done in this table also. But what we had done here, we had assigned this first randomly. Now let us assign this zero first randomly. Let us cross this one, this one. Now if you observe, this row has only one zero. So let us assign this zero. And let us keep these assignments as it is. So this is one more case we have obtained. Now further possibilities are, what are further possibilities? Look here, as we had assigned this zero first and this zero randomly. So we keep these two steps as it is. Now instead of this one, let us assign this and cross these two zeros. So this is shown here. Assign this one and these two will be crossed along the respective rows and columns, and ultimately we will have to make assignment here. Fourth possibility is here. Keep these assignments as it is and interchange these assignments. Interchange these assignments. So ultimately we will get one more solution. So for this assignment problem, it has four alternative solutions. And your final answer will be, we have to write all the four assignments in the assignments. But for calculating of solution, you can take the values corresponding to these cells from original table to determine your optimum value. Now in the next slide, all the assignments are mentioned here, and your total minimum cost is calculated. If you observe here, as we had four various assignments, we noted here all the combinations and we calculated their total minimum cost. So though there are multiple solutions, the cost, total cost is invariant, that is constant. So this is proved here. So this is a special case of assignment problem where such situations arise many times in the day-to-day life. So in the next lecture, we will cover unbalanced assignment problem. Thank you for watching this video.